National Education Policy 2020. This listening part has been recorded and communicated by M.A. Mushtaq Muhiuddin, correspondent, Wings High School, Bhinsa, District Nirmal, and State Organizing Secretary, Telangana Recognized Schools Management's Association, TRSMA, Telangana State, to enable all educationalists across the country to listed become aware of National Education Policy 2020, pick out the pros and cons of it and raise voice if the rights of concerns are violated. You are requested to spare your precious time for 5 hours, listen, note the points which are hazardous to the unity, integrity, secularism, rights and send on WhatsApp number 9640146301. Part 1. Chapter 6. Equitable and Inclusive Education, Learning for All. 6.1. Education is the single greatest tool for achieving social justice and equality. Inclusive and equitable education, while indeed an essential goal in its own right, is also critical to achieving an inclusive and equitable society in which every citizen has the opportunity to dream, thrive, and contribute to the nation. The education system must aim to benefit India's children so that no child loses any opportunity to learn and excel because of circumstances of birth or background. This policy reaffirms that bridging the social category gaps in access, participation, and learning outcomes in school education will continue to be one of the major goals of all education sector development programs. This chapter may be read in conjunction with Chapter 14, which discusses analogous issues of equity and inclusion in higher education. 6.2. While the Indian education system and successive government policies have made steady progress towards bridging gender and social category gaps in all levels of school education, large disparities still remain, especially at the secondary level, particularly for socio-economically disadvantaged groups that have been historically underrepresented in education. Socio-economically disadvantaged groups, SEDGs, can be broadly categorized based on gender identities, particularly female and transgender individuals, socio-cultural identities, such as scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, OBCs, and minorities, geographical identities, such as students from villages, small towns, and aspirational districts, disabilities, including learning disabilities, and socioeconomic conditions, such as migrant communities, low-income households, children in vulnerable situations, victims of or children of victims of trafficking, orphans, including child beggars in urban areas, and the urban poor. While overall enrollments in schools decline steadily from grade 1 to grade 12, this decline in enrollments is significantly more pronounced for many of these SEDGs, with even greater declines for female students within each of these SEDGs and often even steeper in higher education. A brief status overview of the SEDGs that come within socio-cultural identities is given in following subsections. 6.2.1. According to UDICE 2016 and 2017 data, about 19.6% of students belong to scheduled castes at the primary level, but this fraction falls to 17.3% at the higher secondary level. These enrollment drop-offs are more severe for scheduled tribes students, 10.6% to 6.8%, and differently abled children, 1.1% to 0.25%, with even greater declines for female students within each of these categories. The decline in enrollment in higher education is even steeper. 6.2.2. A multiplicity of factors, including lack of access to quality schools, poverty, social mores and customs, and language, have had a detrimental effect on rates of enrollment and retention among the scheduled castes. Bridging these gaps in access, participation, and learning outcomes of children belonging to scheduled castes will continue to be one of the major goals. Also, the other backward classes, OBCs, which have been identified on the basis of historically being socially and educationally backward, also need special focus. 6.2.3. Tribal communities and children from scheduled tribes also face disadvantages at multiple levels due to various historical and geographical factors. Children from tribal communities often find their school education irrelevant and foreign to their lives, both culturally and academically. While several programmatic interventions to uplift children from tribal communities are currently in place and will continue to be pursued, special mechanisms need to be made to ensure that children belonging to tribal communities receive the benefits of these interventions. 6.2.4. Minorities are also relatively underrepresented in school and higher education. The policy acknowledges the importance of interventions to promote education of children belonging to all minority communities, and particularly those communities that are educationally underrepresented. 6.2.5. The policy also recognizes the importance of creating enabling mechanisms for providing children with special needs, CWSN or Divyang, the same opportunities of obtaining quality education as any other child. 6.2.6. Separate strategies will be formulated for focused attention on reducing the social category gaps in school education as outlined in the following subsections. 6.3. The critical problems and recommendations regarding EK, foundational literacy and numeracy, access, enrollment and attendance discussed in chapters 1 to 3 are particularly relevant and important for underrepresented and disadvantaged groups. Therefore, the measures from chapters 1 to 3 will be targeted in a concerted way for SEDGs. 6.4. In addition, there have been various successful policies and schemes such as targeted scholarships, conditional cash transfers to incentivize parents to send their children to school, providing bicycles for transport, etc., that have significantly increased participation of SEDGs in the schooling system in certain areas. These successful policies and schemes must be significantly strengthened across the country. 6.5. It will also be essential to take into account research that ascertains which measures are particularly effective for certain SEDGs. For example, providing bicycles and organizing cycling and walking groups to provide access to school have been shown to be particularly powerful methods in increasing participation of female students, even at lesser distances, because of the safety benefits and comfort to parents that they provide. One-on-one teachers and tutors, peer tutoring, open schooling, appropriate infrastructure, and suitable technological interventions to ensure access can be particularly effective for certain children with disabilities. Schools providing quality EK reap the greatest dividends for children who come from families that are economically disadvantaged. Meanwhile, counselors and or well-trained social workers that work with and connect with students, parents, schools, and teachers in order to improve attendance and learning outcomes have been found to be especially effective for children in urban poor areas. 6.6. Data shows that certain geographical areas contain significantly larger proportions of SEDGs. Also, there are geographical locations that have been identified as aspirational districts which require special interventions for promoting their educational development. Hence, it is recommended that regions of the country with large populations from educationally disadvantaged SEDGs should be declared special education zones, SEZs, where all the schemes and policies are implemented to the maximum through additional concerted efforts, in order to truly change their educational landscape. 6.7. It must be noted that women cut across all underrepresented groups, making up about half of all SEDGs. Unfortunately, the exclusion and inequity that SEDGs face is only amplified for the women in these SEDGs. The policy additionally recognizes the special and critical role that women play in society and in shaping social mores, therefore, providing a quality education to girls is the best way to increase the education levels for these SEDGs, not just in the present but also in future generations. The policy thus recommends that the policies and schemes designed to include students from SEDGs should be especially targeted towards girls in these SEDGs. 6.8. In addition, the Government of India will constitute a Gender Inclusion Fund to build the nation's capacity to provide equitable quality education for all girls as well as transgender students. The fund will be available to states to implement priorities determined by the central government critical for assisting female and transgender children in gaining access to education, such as the provisions of sanitation and toilets, bicycles, conditional cash transfers, etc. Funds will also enable states to support and scale effective community-based interventions that address local context-specific barriers to female and transgender children's access to and participation in education. Similar inclusion fund schemes shall also be developed to address analogous access issues for other SEDGs. In essence, this policy aims to eliminate any remaining disparity in access to education, including vocational education, for children from any gender or other socio-economically disadvantaged group. 6.9. Free boarding facilities will be built, matching the standard of Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas, in school locations where students may have to come from far, and particularly for students who from socio-economically disadvantaged backgrounds, with suitable arrangements for the safety of all children, especially girls. Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalayas will be strengthened and expanded to increase the participation in quality schools, up to grade 12, of girls from socio-economically disadvantaged backgrounds. Additional Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas and Kendriya Vidyalayas will be built around the country, especially in aspirational districts, special education zones, and other disadvantaged areas, to increase high-quality educational opportunities. Preschool sections covering at least 1 year of early childhood care and education will be added to Kendriya Vidyalayas and other primary schools around the nation, particularly in disadvantaged areas. 6.10. Ensuring the inclusion and equal participation of children with disabilities in EK and the schooling system will also be accorded the highest priority. Children with disabilities will be enabled to fully participate in the regular schooling process from the foundational stage to higher education. The Rights of Persons with Disabilities (RPWD) Act 2016 defines inclusive education as a system of education wherein students with and without disabilities learn together and the system of teaching and learning is suitably adapted to meet the learning needs of different types of students with disabilities. This policy is in complete consonance with the provisions of the RPWD Act 2016 and endorses all its recommendations with regard to school education. While preparing the National Curriculum Framework, NCERT will ensure that consultations are held with expert bodies such as National Institutes of DePoNT. 6.11. To this end, schools and school complexes will be provided resources for the integration of children with disabilities, recruitment of special educators with cross-disability training, and for the establishment of resource centers, wherever needed, especially for children with severe or multiple disabilities. Barrier-free access for all children with disabilities will be enabled as per the RPWD Act. Different categories of children with disabilities have differing needs. Schools and school complexes will work and be supported for providing all children with disabilities accommodations and support mechanisms tailored to suit their needs and to ensure their full participation and inclusion in the classroom. In particular, assistive devices and appropriate technology-based tools, as well as adequate and language-appropriate teaching learning materials, e.g., textbooks in accessible formats such as large print and braille, will be made available to help children with disabilities integrate more easily into classrooms and engage with teachers and their peers. This will apply to all school activities including arts, sports, and vocational education. NIOS will develop high-quality modules to teach Indian Sign Language and to teach other basic subjects using Indian Sign Language. Adequate attention will be paid to the safety and security of children with disabilities. 6.12. As per the RPWD Act 2016, children with benchmark disabilities shall have the choice of regular or special schooling. Resource centers in conjunction with special educators will support the rehabilitation and educational needs of learners with severe or multiple disabilities and will assist parents, guardians in achieving high-quality homeschooling and skilling for such students as needed. Home-based education will continue to be a choice available for children with severe and profound disabilities who are unable to go to schools. The children under home-based education must be treated as equal to any other child in the general system. There shall be an audit of home-based education for its efficiency and effectiveness using the principle of equity and equality of opportunity. Guidelines and standards for home-based schooling shall be developed based on this audit in line with the RPWD Act 2016. While it is clear that the education of all children with disabilities is the responsibility of the state, technology-based solutions will be used for the orientation of parents and caregivers along with wide-scale dissemination of learning materials to enable parents and caregivers to actively support their children's learning needs will be accorded priority. 6.13. Most classrooms have children with specific learning disabilities who need continuous support. Research is clear that the earlier such support begins, the better the chances of progress. Teachers must be helped to identify such learning disabilities early and plan specifically for their mitigation. Specific actions will include the use of appropriate technology allowing and enabling children to work at their own pace, with flexible curricula to leverage each child's strengths, and creating an ecosystem for appropriate assessment and certification. Assessment and certification agencies, including the proposed new National Assessment Center, PARAC, will formulate guidelines and recommend appropriate tools for conducting such assessment, from the foundational stage to higher education, including for entrance exams, in order to ensure equitable access and opportunities for all students with learning disabilities. 6.14. The awareness and knowledge of how to teach children with specific disabilities, including learning disabilities, will be an integral part of all teacher education programs, along with gender sensitization and sensitization towards all underrepresented groups in order to reverse their underrepresentation. 6.15. Alternative forms of schools will be encouraged to preserve their traditions or alternative pedagogical styles. At the same time, they will be supported to integrate the subject and learning areas prescribed by the NCFSE into their curricula in order to reduce and eventually eliminate the underrepresentation of children from these schools in higher education. In particular, financial assistance will be provided to introduce science, mathematics, social studies, Hindi, English, state languages, or other relevant subjects in the curriculum, as may be desired by these schools. This would enable children studying in these schools to attain the learning outcomes defined for grades 1 to 12. Furthermore, students in such schools would be encouraged to appear for state or other board examinations and assessments by the NTA, and thereby enroll in higher education institutions. Capacities of teachers in the teaching of science, mathematics, language, and social studies will be developed, including orientation to new pedagogical practices. Libraries and laboratories will be strengthened, and adequate reading materials like books, journals, etc., and other teaching learning materials will be made available. 6.16. Within SEDGs, and with respect to all the above policy points, special attention will be given to reduce the disparities in the educational development of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes.
As a part of the efforts to enhance participation in school education,
special hostels in dedicated regions, bridge courses, and financial assistance through fee waivers and scholarships will be offered to talented and meritorious students from all SEDGs on a larger scale, especially at the secondary stage of education, to facilitate their entry into higher education. 6.17. Under the aegis of the Ministry of Defence, state governments may encourage opening NCC wings in their secondary and higher secondary schools, including those located in tribal-dominated areas. This will enable harnessing of the natural talent and unique potential of students, which in turn would help them to aspire to a successful career in the defence forces. 6.18. All scholarships and other opportunities and schemes available to students from SEDGs will be coordinated and announced by a single agency and website to ensure that all students are aware of and may apply in a simplified manner on such a single window system, as per eligibility. 6.19. All the above policies and measures are absolutely critical to attaining full inclusion and equity for all SEDGs, but they are not sufficient. What is also required is a change in school culture. All participants in the school education system, including teachers, principals, administrators, counselors, and students, will be sensitized to the requirements of all students, the notions of inclusion and equity, and the respect, dignity, and privacy of all persons. Such an educational culture will provide the best pathway to help students become empowered individuals who, in turn, will enable society to transform into one that is responsible towards its most vulnerable citizens. Inclusion and equity will become a key aspect of teacher education and training for all leadership, administrative, and other positions in schools. Efforts will be made to recruit more high-quality teachers and leaders from SEDGs in order to bring in excellent role models for all students. 6.20. Students will be sensitized through this new school culture, brought in by teachers, trained social workers and counselors, as well as through corresponding changes to bring in an inclusive school curriculum. The school curriculum will include, early on, material on human values such as respect for all persons, empathy, tolerance, human rights, gender equality, non-violence, global citizenship, inclusion, and equity. It would also include more detailed knowledge of various cultures, religions, languages, gender identities, etc. to sensitize and develop respect for diversity.
Any biases and stereotypes in school curriculum will be removed, and more material will be included that is relevant and relatable to all communities.
Thank you for listening. Continue to listen to the Chapter 7 of Part 1, School Education, with the next clip.